Greetings, and welcome to the introductory video for the Rock and Roll Spock. On this channel, I will be talking about various things which tickle my fancy, be it books, which I'm a fan of most books, mainly science fiction, fantasy, horror. Some of my favorite authors include Stephen King, Frank Herbert, and various others. Also, comic books. I'm not a Marvel or DC kind of guy. I read both. One can like both, after all. Movies, which I'm a fan of, damn near anything. Don't usually go for romantic comedies. There has to be something really different about it for me to go for it. Some of my favorite films include the original Star Wars trilogy, and always remember Han shot first and last. The first Matrix movie. I think they ruined it with the last two. Fan of the Nightmare on Elm Street movies. Most slasher movies in general. Like I said, they're just good fun sometimes. Also, favorite film would probably be Requiem for a Dream, but we'll talk about that some other time. Also, gaming. I'm a fan of... I play video games quite avidly. Usually quite avidly. My favorite video game of all time, Super Mario 3. Hands down. Best video game ever. I do some tabletop gaming. Collectible miniatures, collectible cards, and role-playing games such as Dungeons & Dragons. But, anywho. Let's move on to the meat of the video, shall we? Which will be a review of the movie Ender's Game. Ender's Game is based on the novel by Orson Scott Card. It's a good book, but I highly suggest reading it. But anyways, that's enough about... For now, enough about that. The movie is visually stunning, well acted, and it, for the most part, it's well written. However, having read the book, I had my share of problems with it. And in this case, if you haven't seen the movie and wish to do so without knowing details, especially if you've read the book, spoilers, and I would highly recommend not continuing with the video when that can. And it, but still, like, share, subscribe. And also, pertinent links are going to be down in the information box below. Anyways. Alright, so now that hopefully anyone who doesn't want any spoilers is gone. Spoilers. The fact that they completely took out the subplot involving Peter's brother and sister and their political essays really hurt things, in my opinion. Even just a slight mention of it would have been fine. Also, the fact that Peter was relegated to just being a very minor character. We see he really only shows up for two sequences, and one of them he's not even Peter. The fact that the fellow student who was bullying Ender in the beginning of the book, rather than being killed by Ender's beating, was just simply hospitalized, kind of gets me, as that is an important part of Ender's evolution as a person. Also, the fact that whether or not Bonzo died from his injuries or not is also an important part of Ender's evolution that is left out. We're left to just presume he died. From Battle School forward, everything seems incredibly rushed. There are whole segments of the movie that really needed to be there. Training with his Jeesh, his fellow students in the Battle School, needed to be there. Just the free time training that they did needed to be in there because of how important that is for the battle simulations. They run in the battle school, especially once Ender gets his own, gets his own command in the school. Let's see. The ending and the fact that everything about the ending happens on the same planet as the command school. Just again, it feels like they were told, "Hey, don't make it any longer than this," and they said, "Okay, we'll make sure to make it less than that substantially." And I'm really, really hoping that for at least the Peter and Valentine stuff, that at least there's a director's cut that will be coming out that will have something to mention those as that whole subplot, as that is, in my opinion, extremely important. This also does go into the subplot, however, also does build up the fact that Peter becomes a world ruler. That is actually how that happens, is because of his political essays. Anyway, all that being said, though, it was a good movie, and I highly recommend watching it. Visually stunning. The fleets, the battle school itself, just amazing looking. Also, if you've never read the book, pick it up. You might, it's a good read. And hey, who knows, you might like it. Anyway, all that being said, this is the Rock and Roll Spock signing off. Live long, rock hard.